So our goal today is to scan or photograph our sketch, get it into Photoshop, and format it to its proper size, which is 8 by 10 inches, okay? And it will be 300 pixels per inch. Oops. Pixels per inch. All right. Once we format that, we might end the video and start a new video on optimizing its color. So we'll get rid of the smudges, okay? We'll get rid of the wrinkles and my hand over here and the cement on the side. And just clean it all up. And then we'll begin to set up our layers, okay? And then paint and design. So let me put layers in here as well. Okay, and then we'll save it for later before we move on to the next part of designing this book cover. So about scanning and photographing our sketches, scanning is the best, of course. It's nice to have it flat on a scanning bed. It gets rid of all the light tinting, the incandescent lights or reflections. It flattens that paper out. But being where we are now during the pandemic, I know that not a lot of you are going to have access to a scanner. So we need to photograph these images. Now you have to have, I would suggest, at least a 10 megapixel camera. Your phones might do okay if they've got about 10 megapixels. But if they don't, you'll need to get a digital camera from somebody and take it before you move it onto the computer. All right. These images, let me show you what I have here. I took this outside because as I did some inside, like these, they're a little yellower and the light was a little bit darker, so this was the maximum brightness I could get. Now, I could work with this, but the problem is I have to adjust in the image more and fix it more. So every time I fix an image, it degrades the original image. So I want to try and get it as nice as possible before I start editing that image in Photoshop. So I went outside and took some in sunlight. This is a little shaded with the cloud, so it's a little blue tinted. And that one is more neutral. Okay, so I think I'll use that one. It looks like there's not a lot of reflections. Couldn't get away from a lot of these things that were damaged, wrinkling, smudges, but I'm going to use Photoshop to get rid of that. All right, so how to bring it into Photoshop. I could drag this image directly onto Photoshop, and it will open. I can right-click and open it that way, okay? Or I can just open Photoshop and do file open. Okay. Notice that a lot of these menus are like file and edit are a lot like Word or other programs. So don't be so intimidated by Photoshop. Know that a lot of these things are in the same spot. So you've got file, new, file open. You've got file print, save, save as, close, all these things that you've seen before. So I'm going to go file open. I'm going to find that sketch, so I'll go to downloads, that's where I put it. This one, is it that one or is it that one? That's my neutral one, my more neutral one, so I'm going to hit open. Okay, and there it is. So this is what you should see initially when you open up Photoshop. Okay, I've got all of my palettes windows over here. I've got my toolbar over here. Okay, so there's my toolbar. As I hover over each one of those, it gives me a little tutorial on how it works. It shows me a key command that makes it easy and quick to go to it. So rather than going over here and clicking on that, I can just hit the Y key and it will go to the history brush tool. All right. every time I pick a tool, it changes the options up here in the options bar. So if I click on the crop tool, it gives me crop options. If I click on the move tool, it gives me move options. If I'm working on the canvas and I have multiple things selected, it will give me options up here for that as well. So it really pays attention to what I'm doing and gives me options to help with what I'm doing. So the options bar constantly changes. The palettes that we need for this, the windows, are layers. Okay, notice it's checked, so it's up. This is my layers palette. Okay, I need my layers palette. I need my swatches and my color because I'm going to be doing some painting later. And I need my brushes, okay, to select the different brushes. If you do not see any of these palettes, just go up here and find it that way. So notice that brushes isn't checked, so it's not really visible. But if I go window brushes, it pops up. I can also drag these palettes around and have them stand out here freely. I can grab the tab, move it back in, and pair it with that. I can bring it over here and have it be on its own layer here. And I think that's what I will do. I'll leave layers right here, brushes and color. In fact, I'll just drag layers here. Notice I get a little blue highlight, and it's asking me, it's kind of showing me that if I drop it right now, it's going to combine it with those tabs. But if I drag it a little further, it's going to drop it in between those. So that's what I wanted. All right. So we're pretty much set up, ready to go. Now all I have to do is, we've opened it up in Photoshop, so we have to format the size and the resolution. Okay. So just to show you quickly, I'll go to Image Menu, Image Size, and you can see that this image total pixels are 4,032 by 3,024. Its width is 56 inches and its height is 42 inches at 72 pixels per inch. So that means that if I divide my total amount of pixels by 72 pixels per inch, this is how big it is. Okay, it's 56 inches by 42 inches. But if I change it to be 300 pixels per inch, I'm dividing the total amount of pixels by 300, which will make the size in inches go down, right? Because I'm dividing by a larger number. So I'll hit 300. Crud, I'm using math for art. What the freak? I never knew I'd have to do that. No, I'm just kidding. So hopefully you made it to division and addition and subtraction. So putting 300 into these numbers, the total amount of pixels, I get 13.5 inches ish by 10 inches. Okay. Now I could hit OK and I'd be halfway there in my formatting, but I want to show you how to do it in one swoop. Okay. So I'm going to hit cancel. And before I do that, I need to orient my image the proper way. So I don't want it on its side. I'm going to go image, image rotation, and change it, do a 90 degree clockwise rotation, okay? And there we go. If I did it the wrong way, I can always hit Command Z, okay? That's undo. Command Z is great. If I keep hitting Command Z, it undoes what I do. There's also the history palette, and you can see it lists everything that I do as I do it. And I can just come back and toggle through those if I want to start over again at some point. Okay? All right, so now that it's the proper orientation, I'm going to use the crop tool to size it correctly. Okay? So I'll click on the crop tool. I immediately get these crop lines. And in the options, I want to select width, height, and resolution. So the width is 8, height is 10 inches, of course, And then resolution is 300 pixels per inch. So all I have to do is type in 8 inches, 8 IN, 10 IN, and 300 pixels per inch. Okay. Good. All right. So I'm ready to move these crop lines around and cut out anything that I don't want. Okay. I can click in the middle and move it around. I can go to the corners and scale the crop lines down. Okay. I can go a little further out and rotate. Okay, if I think I took a picture of it a little crooked, I can rotate it. But I don't think I need to rotate mine. I think it looks pretty good as it is. Okay. And when I get it to where I want, I'm going to double click it to finish the crop, or I can hit this little check mark up here and that'll finish the crop. Okay, so I'll double click it. And now after I've double clicked it, it is now formatted 8 inches by 10 inches and 300 pixels per inch. And just to prove it to you, I'll go to image size, and you can see 8 inches by 10 inches, 300 pixels per inch. Great. And the total amount of pixels is different too. So the crop tool actually got rid of all the extra pixels that I didn't need, which is nice. Okay. So I'll hit OK. And I'm going to save it at this point in case anything happens. I don't want Photoshop to crash. A good habit is to save early and save often. So many times I preach that, people let it go in one ear and out the other. Their project crashes after working on it the whole 2 hours of class, and they ask if they can get it back, and they can't get it back. There's nothing I can do. I can't perform any magic. It's just not there anymore. So save early and save often. So I'm going to go File, Save As, because I haven't saved it yet. It doesn't have a new name or anything. I'm going to call this Book Portrait Book Cover. I wanted a PSD. I wanted a Photoshop document because the native file format is the best file format for any program. So a Photoshop document you want to save as a PSD, as your master file. It keeps the layers, it keeps the file size optimized and as low as possible. It doesn't become huge, so it's hard to transport or send to somebody else. So PSD is really the best option when you're planning on going back in and editing that file. So, Portrait Book Cover PSD. Okay, notice I can do other file formats, but I'm just going to do Photoshop. Hey, it's first for a reason. Okay, I'll hit save and then hit OK. Cool. Oh, one thing it asked when I saved it was, do you want to maximize compatibility? And what that means is I've got this turned on to remind me every time I save it. That's the default for Photoshop, and you can change that in the Photoshop preferences. But I like it reminding me if I want to maximize compatibility. And this will allow me to open it up in older Photoshop versions without any problems. Okay, so I'll leave maximize compatibility. If you don't want to see it again, just click don't show again, and I'll hit OK. All right, so that concludes our first session of this book cover. We've got it in Photoshop. It's now the right size. Now we're ready to set up the layers and begin coloring and designing that. So I'll see you in the next video.